continue English grammar lesson number 4 direct and indirect speech. Children, in the previous session we learned what are direct and indirect speech, right? What is a direct speech? When we quote the exact words of the speaker without any change is called what? Direct speech. When we quote the exact words of the speaker without any change is called direct speech. And what is an indirect speech? When we narrate or give the summary of the words used by the speaker but not the exact words are called what? Indirect speech. Okay, and we learned the changes in tense as well, right? And today we will learn changes in pronoun, when the pronoun will change while converting a direct to indirect speech. Okay, now we'll see pronoun changes. No change in pronouns. The pronoun will not change in some cases. We will see when they won't change. When the speaker is in the first person, the pronoun does not change in indirect speech. When the speaker is in the first person, what do you mean by first, second and third person? First person is I, we, me, us, mine, our, ours. Okay? Second person, you, your, yours. And third person, he, she, it, they, his, him, her, hers, its, etc. Children, we have already learned this, right? So, when the speaker is in the first person, then the pronoun does not change in indirect speech. See the example, direct speech. I said, I have cut my finger. Here, what is who is the speaker? The speaker is in first person, I, right? I is the first person. So, when the speaker is in the first person, then the pronoun does not change in indirect speech. See, here, I have cut my finger. Here, when you change to indirect speech, the pronoun, there is no change in pronoun. Okay, I said that, the same only, I have only will change to had. Past tense of cut is cut itself. So, I had cut my finger. I said that. You have to use conjunction that, right? After the reporting verb. I said that I had cut my finger. Here, the pronoun does not change in indirect speech. When the speaker is in the first person, okay, then the pronoun does not change in indirect speech. Next, when the speaker is in the second or third person and is talking about someone else, the pronoun in the quoted words does not change. Next point, when the speaker is in the second or third person, when the speaker is in second or third person and is talking about, and the second or third person is talking about someone else, okay, then the pronoun in the quoted words does not change. See the example, direct speech. You said he has cut his finger. Here, who is the speaker? The speaker is in second person. You, second person, right? You said he has cut his finger. He is talking about someone, right? He, someone, right? He is talking about someone. Then, the pronoun will not change in indirect speech. So, see how it is converted in indirect speech. You said that he had cut his finger. Here, the pronoun did not change, because the speaker is in second person. Okay, so you can rewrite in indirect speech as you said that he had cut his finger. Okay, see one more example. He said she has cut her finger. Here he is in what? This is in third person, right? He is in third person, second or third person, right? If the speaker is in second or third person and they are talking about someone else, then the pronoun does not change in indirect speech. He, see here, he is the third person. He said she has cut her finger, talking about someone, right? So the pronoun will not change. See now how we can convert to indirect speech. He said that. She, no change, same only, she had cut her finger. Okay. Next we will see when the pronoun will change. Okay. Children, now take page number 63. Let's see when the pronoun will change. Okay.
When the speaker is in the second or third person and is talking about himself or herself, the pronoun in the quoted words changes in the following manner. So, when the pronoun will change when the speaker is in the second or third person, okay, and is talking about himself or herself. What we learned earlier, when the speaker is in the second or third person and is talking about someone else, then the pronoun in the quoted words does not change. Now, when the speaker is in the second or third person and is talking about himself or herself, not about someone else, okay? If they were talking about himself or herself, then the pronoun in the quoted word changes. See the example. First one, direct speech. You said, I have cut my finger. The speaker is in second person. You is the second person, right? You said, I have cut my finger. He is talking about himself, right? So, the pronoun will change. See, in indirect speech, you said that, I changed to you. You had cut your finger. My changed to your. You said that you had cut your finger. Next example, direct speech. He said, I have cut my finger. He is in what? Third person, right? And he is talking about himself. So, the pronoun will change. The pronoun in the quoted words will change. See, in indirect speech, he said that I changed to he. He had cut my changed to his. He had cut his finger. Okay. Next, when the speaker is a proper noun and is talking about himself or herself, the pronoun in the quoted word changes. Next, when the speaker is a proper noun means what? Name of a person, right? When the speaker is a proper noun and the speaker is talking about himself or herself, then the pronoun will change. See the example, direct speech. Ravi said, I have cut my finger. He is talking about himself, right? And Ravi is what? Proper noun. So, when it comes to indirect speech, Ravi said that, I changed to he. He had cut his finger. Next example, direct speech. Shweta said, I have cut my finger. Shweta, proper noun, right? So, when it comes to indirect speech, Shweta said that, I changed to she. Okay, name a girl, right? So, she had cut her finger. Okay. So, children, once again, I'll repeat, change in pronoun. When the pronoun will change, when the speaker is in the second or third person, and if they are talking about himself or herself, then the pronoun will change. Then, when the speaker is a proper noun and is talking about himself or herself, then the pronoun will change. Okay? Next, imperative sentences. You know imperative sentences, right? Imperative sentences express what? Orders, requests, or advice. When we report an imperative sentence, we use a reporting verb such as ordered, requested, advised, etc. So, when we report an imperative sentence express orders, requests, or advice, right? When we report an imperative sentence, we use reporting verbs such as ordered. We have to use ordered, requested, or advised, etc. depending upon the sentence. Which indicates a command or request, and then use the infinitive which expresses action to be carried out. See the example, direct speech. The teacher said to the students, do not talk in the class. This is an imperative sentence, right? It's an order, right? So, the teacher said to the students, do not talk in the class. In direct speech, how can we convert into indirect speech? The teacher said to, okay, said to, we can change to ordered, okay, we have learned here, right? See, we have to use a reporting verb such as ordered, requested, advised, etc. So, here the teacher ordered the students, right? Do not talk in the class. So, we have to use the reporting verb ordered. Okay. Then they have said that use the infinitive. We have learned in the previous lesson modal verbs, right? Infinitive with and without to. So, here we have to use with infinitive only. Okay. Without to. So, we don't need to write to here. The teacher ordered the students not to talk in the class. Next example, Please give me something to eat, the old man said to them. What kind of sentence it is? Imperative sentence, a request, right? Please give me something to eat. It's a request. So we can write, the old man said to them. We can change in indirect speech as the old man. Instead of said, we can write requested, because it is a request, right? The old man requested them. No need to add to, okay? It should be in infinitive form. The old man requested them to give him something to eat. Next, interrogative sentences. When changing an interrogative sentence from direct to indirect speech, we have to see, change the reporting verb into asked or inquired. When changing the interrogative sentence, asking question sentence are called interrogative sentence, right? When changing an interrogative sentence from direct to indirect speech, change the reporting verb into asked or inquired. Then change the question mark to full stop. We have learned, right, in indirect sentence, we won't put question mark, exclamation marks, nothing, right? We have to put full stop. So change the question mark to a full stop. In yes or no type of questions, when the sentence begins with a verb, whether or if is used, okay? If the answer to the question is yes or no, okay, then you have, and when the sentence begins with a verb, then you have to use whether or if. Make tense, pronoun and other changes according to the rules already stated. See the example, direct speech. Kareem said to Anita, do you like mangoes? This is an interrogative sentence, and here the question begins with what? Not a question word, right? This is what? This starts with, the question starts with a verb, right? So how can we convert into indirect speech? Kareem asked. We have learned that, right? The change the reporting verb into asked or inquired. So instead of said to, we have to write asked. Kareem asked Anita if she liked mangoes. We should not put question mark. We have to put full stop. The question started with, the sentence begins with a verb. So we have to use whether or if. So Kareem asked Anita if she liked mangoes. Next example, we said to her, where were you last Sunday? So in indirect speech we can write, we asked her where she was the previous Sunday. Last Sunday will change into previous Sunday. See children, you have to learn this, children, then only you will be able to write in indirect speech. Okay, now I'll just read the following examples to understand how the words change in indirect speech. Direct speech, one example with will. She said, I will teach English tomorrow. How can we change into indirect speech? She said that she would teach English tomorrow. Will change to would in indirect speech. Next, can. She said, I can teach English grammar. Can will change to could. So she said that she could teach English grammar. Next, must. She said, I must have a book to teach English. Must will change to had to in indirect speech. So she said that she had to have a book to teach English. Next, shall. She said, what shall we learn today? Shall will change to should. She asked. It's a question, right? It's a question, interrogative sentence. So we have to use asked or inquired, right? So we have to use she asked what we should learn today. Then no question mark at the end. Next, may. She said, may I start a new chapter? This is also an interrogative sentence. But starting sentence begins with what? A verb, right? This is not a question word. It's a verb. So it will change in indirect speech as she asked if she might start a new chapter. Okay, children, you have to read the rules properly. Then only you will be able to convert from direct to indirect speech. Now we will move on to the TB exercises. B main, change the following into indirect speech. He said, I have won. How can we change into indirect speech? He said that he had won. this is in third person, right? And he is talking about himself, so the pronoun will change. He said that he had won. That conjunction we have to use. Next, Rakib asked me, are you going to Delhi? You can change and write in indirect speech as Rakib asked me. This is what interrogative sentence and started with what? A verb. So you can use whether or if. Whether I was going to Delhi. Next, he said, I wish I knew. Third person talking about himself, so the pronoun will change. He said that he wished he knew. Alice said, how clever I am. Alice exclaimed how clever she was. It's an exclamatory sentence, so we are using the reporting verb exclaimed. Next, he said, let's wait for her return. He said that they should wait for her return. Next, Dad said, Bengaluru is a beautiful city. We can change and write in indirect speech as Dad said that Bengaluru is a beautiful city. Next, Kabir said, I am waiting for you here. How can we change and write? Kabir said that I changed to he. He was waiting for you, changed to me. Here became there. Kabir said that he was waiting for me there. Next, you can borrow my book, said Mohit. Mohit said that I could borrow his book. Next, Simain changed the following into indirect speech. He said she is coming this week. How can we change and write? He said that she was coming that week. Is coming changed to was coming. Present continuous changed to past continuous. This week changed to that week. Next, what do you want? She asked him. She asked him what he wanted. Next, which way should I go? Asked the little girl. The little girl asked which way she should go. Next, the train is coming, said Rosie. Rosie said that the train was coming. Next, Robin said to me, I shall see you tomorrow. Robin said to me that he should see me the next day. Tomorrow will change to next day. So, right, Robin said to me that he should see me the next day. Next, are you coming with us? He asked me. How can we change and write? He asked me if I was coming with them. Our beginning sentence are right a verb. So, we have to use if or whether. He asked me if I was coming with them. Next, Karuna said, who has taken my pen? It's an interrogative sentence, right? So, the reporting will verb we have to use asked or inquire, right? Karuna asked, who had taken her pen? Has taken changed to had taken. My became her. Karuna asked, who had taken her pen? Next, we have finished our homework, said the girls. The girls said that they had finished their homework. So children, all of you, copy this in your textbook without mistakes. Read the rules clearly, thoroughly, then only you will be able to convert from direct to indirect speech. Okay? If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the interactive session. Thank you.